Welcome to Electromagnetics playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you example based on EM wave and Poynting theorem in this session. So in this session, I'll cover one example which includes solution of all previous topic which I have explained you based on EM wave and Poynting theorem. So in single example, I'll cover all points. So let us have a question first. So I'm writing it over here. So see, in this question, the time domain expression for magnetic field of plane wave traveling in non-magnetic medium. So see, here this term is very important. Non-magnetic medium. What is the meaning of non-magnetic medium? Meaning of non-magnetic medium is it has relative permeability and that is equals to 1, right? So all those data that we need to mention over here, relative permeability mu r, that is equals to 1 over here, as per this is non-magnetic medium, and that is given by h of xt. So h of xt, that is equals to 0.5 cos of 6 pi into 10 to the power 8 t minus 10x into az direction in terms of ampere per meter, right? And first question is find the direction of wave propagation, right? So we will solve all questions step by step. So see, first of all, how many data that is there with us based on this equation? Let us write it. So here, first of all, we need to understand and we need to compare this equation with standard equation. So if you write standard equation in terms of xt, then that has to be h0 into e to the power minus alpha z into cos of omega t minus beta. Now here, instead of z, this is propagating in x direction, so I'm writing it is x into az direction in terms of ampere per meter. So from this we can find unknown parameters, right? Where we can say right now this is what time domain expression, right? So this omega, that is 6 pi into 10 to the power 8, beta is 10, mu r, that is 1. So let me mention that omega is equals to 6 pi into 10 to the power 8, beta, that is 10, right? And mu, as per non-magnetic medium, it is 1. And value of h0 that we can find, that is 0.5. Now we have the basic datas and we are dealing with to find direction of wave propagation. So here we should know, see, this parameter indicates direction of wave propagation. So here x, so here it should be in x direction. So direction of propagation, that is there in x direction, and it is there in positive x direction, right? So this parameter means first calculation, that is there in positive x direction. So this is first answer. Now see, second, the dielectric constant and intrinsic impedance, that is what we are dealing with to calculate, right? Now see, we have value of beta, we have value of mu r. So by using beta and mu r, we can calculate epsilon r, dielectric constant. So how to calculate that? So see, basic formula for lossless medium, we can say beta is equals to omega into mu epsilon, and this beta, that is omega into mu 0 mu r, epsilon 0 epsilon r. Now we have all the datas. So beta is 10, omega is 6 pi into 10 to the power 8 into, see, this is what, square root of mu r, that is 1, right? So I'm just saying, like, see, this is what square root of mu 0 epsilon 0 into square root of epsilon r, and 1 by square root of mu 0 epsilon 0, that is velocity of light. So we can directly say it will be square root of epsilon r is equals to 10 into c, c is velocity of light, divided by 6 pi into 10 to the power 8. So this is 10 into 3 into 10 to the power 8 divided by 6 pi into 10 to the power 8. So let us solve this. Right, and that is what value of square root of epsilon r. So from this we can say epsilon r is square of this. So let us square it. So this is 2.54 roughly. So epsilon r, that is 2.54 approximately. So this is our second answer. Now in second answer, there is one more thing that is there, that is intrinsic impedance. So what is intrinsic impedance? See, intrinsic impedance, that we can calculate by two ways, right? And one of that way for lossless medium that I have already explained, eta is equals to square root of mu by epsilon, and mu is mu 0 mu r, and epsilon is epsilon 0 epsilon r. And see, mu 0, that is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, and mu r, that is 1, which is given to us. Epsilon 0, that is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12, and epsilon r, that we have calculated, 2.54. So let us solve this. So this is 236.32. So 236 roughly, I can say this is what intrinsic impedance over here, right? Now see, third question, that is time domain expression of electric field. And electric field time domain expression, that is what we are delivered to identify from magnetic field, which is given to us over here, right? And one thing that we should know, like, direction of propagation for electric field will be even in x direction only. But here, if you observe magnetic field variation, that is happening along with z direction. So as per right hand thumb rule, we can find direction of electric field. So let me write that step by step, and then I'll write that. So electric field, that is E0 e to the power minus alpha x into cos of omega t minus beta x into direction, right? Now unit is there in terms of volt per meter. Now what will be the direction? Now you see, direction of propagation, that is happening along with x direction. See, so x is there in this direction, and magnetic field, that is happening in z direction. So magnetic field is there in this direction, z direction, right? So if you use right hand thumb rule, right, then as per right hand thumb rule, we need to rotate this electric field with respect to z. So it will be there in this direction, that is y direction, right? So direction of propagation of electric field, that will be there in y direction, I need to write this is ay. Now we need to calculate what is E0 into this. So this is already one for lossless, this is one, right? So we need to calculate E0. Now how to calculate E0? So based on intrinsic impedance, so intrinsic impedance, that is E by H. So we can say this E0 by H0, so E0 is equals to eta into H0, eta that we have calculated, 236 into H0, that is given to us 0.5. So if you place this, you will be getting this is 118, right? So E0, that is 118. So I can write Now this E is equals to 118 cos of omega, that we have 6 pi into 10 to the power 8 t minus 10 x into ay direction volt per meter. Now last question is average power density, right? So average power density, that we can calculate as per Poynting theorem, and this is what answer of our third question. And next is average power density. So average power density for lossless medium, it is E0 square by 2 eta. E0 that we have calculated, 118 square divided by 2 eta. Eta is 236. So if you solve this, it is 29.5. So 29.5 watt per meter square, that will be average power density. So this is my fourth question's answer. I hope that you have understood this. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. Definitely, based on your suggestions, in future I'll make videos which will solve your queries. Thank you so much for watching this video.